Hello everyone, today in this video we will be discussing the question, a question which is asked in the FAANG interviews, which means the Facebook, Amazon, Google, Microsoft and all. So in these companies the question is asked regarding the finding the mirror of a binary tree. Okay, so let's first discuss what is a tree. Okay, let's start from the basics. What is a tree? Okay, tree is like it will have a node here and it will have some numbers or other information which will be connected in this fashion. Okay, this is known as a tree. And we can have numbers here like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay, these are the numbers. It's not necessarily that we should have in order. We can have any numbers. Okay, so this basically a tree, and what we have to find is the mirror of a binary tree. Okay, what does mirror mean? Suppose that I have a tree like, let's take a small example, 1, 2, 3 and 4. This is a tree which I have. To find the mirror of this tree, what I have to do is I have to divide this tree like this, means the diagram I have to make into two parts and I have to draw like this. Okay, 1 and 3 will be drawn like this. Here we'll have 3 and here we'll have 4 and 2 will be here. This is a mirror of a binary tree. Now let's approach how to make this tree will be given to us. We have to output this tree. Okay, how to do that? Let's see the approach of the question. Okay, one thing you can observe, wherever we have null, let's write it as n. Okay, so here we have null and here we have null. Okay, so let's do the same thing here as well. Now after writing the null points here, what you can observe is starting from the fourth node. Okay, this is the fourth node here. Let's mark it as fourth node. Okay, this is the fourth node here. The fourth node has two children, which is the left child and the right child. Okay, the left child is null as well as the right child is null. So in this also it is the same thing here, left and right child is null. Okay, so let's move to 3. Okay, in 3 the left child is null whereas the right child is 4. In the mirror of a binary tree, what you can observe is the right child is 4 whereas the left child is null. Okay, so this thing has been exchanged. See, it was null and 4, but it became 4 and null. Okay, so the exchange between the left and the right child is happening. Okay, in the mirror of a binary tree. Like that, the same thing goes for 2 also. Since 2 has null, the change won't be observed here. Let's move to 1. 1 has two child, which is 2 in the left child and 3 in the right child. Okay, when we are exchanging that with 2 and 3, we are in the mirror, we are having 3 and 2. Okay, so basically what's our main aim? Our main aim is to access each node and then exchange its left child with right child. The same thing we'll be doing for each node. Okay, first we'll do for 1, it will be exchanged, then we'll do for 3 also, and then we'll do for 4 also. Same thing with 2 also. Okay, after we do this, we'll obtain the mirror of a binary tree. Let's write down what are the steps involved in it. Okay, so what are the steps involved is, first we have to travel to each node, and second is, after traveling to each node, what we have to print is the we have to exchange the left and right child. Okay, so to do that we'll be using post order traversal. What does post order traversal mean? Post order, by the name only we can make it out. Like, what is post order? We'll have L and R, then N. This is the code for remembering the post order. This means that first we will visit the left child, then we will go to right child, then node will be printed. For example, if you consider this case, okay, let's consider this case here. Here we have the nodes 1, 2, 3 and 4. What is the post order traversal of this one? First, what we will do? It is L and R, right? It is L and R means L, R, N. Okay, first it will go to 1, then it will go to left part, then again it will go to left part. Here it is null, okay. So if it is null, what does that mean? Null means it will not be printed. Nothing will be printed. Then it will go to the N, then it will go to R. Okay, first left, then right will be checked, then null, then the node will be printed. Okay, so let me write down here. L, R, N. Left, right, then node. Okay. Left, right, then node. Okay. So here we have left and it's empty here. So first it's empty here and here also it's empty, so N will be printed. Okay, first 2 will be printed, so our first output is 2. Okay, so let's write down here 2. Then after that, what will be the
after 2 is printed, we have to check again this one. For 1 also, L, R and N will be checked, okay. So, L is done for 1, then R will be checked. R is 3, okay. Then again, L, R and N will be checked for 3 also. Then, L will be checked, it's null, it will go to R, R is 4. Here also, L, R, N will be started and L is null and R is null and 4 is there. So, 4 will be printed. Then after that gets over, you will come here. Since left and right is over, 3 will be printed. Then again we'll come here. Since the left part is traversed and the right part is traversed, 1 will be printed. So the so the order in which the elements will be printed is 2, 4, 3, 1. Okay. So instead of printing the values, what we'll be doing is whenever we travel to any node, what we'll be doing is here we'll be exchanging the left and the right child. Okay. Means L is checked, R is checked. Then instead of printing the node as 2 here, what we'll be doing, we'll be exchanging the childs here. So this is done exchange, then we'll come here, then we'll come here, here also we'll exchange the child. Then we'll come here also we'll exchange the child. And after that, finally at the root node, we'll exchange 2 and 3. So it will become 3 and 2. Okay. So that's what we are going to do in this program. So I've written the code here. So basically to create every node here, as you can see here, the nodes are there, right? This node is nothing but a structure, okay? It's defined by a keyword struct and it will have three things. Int info to store the number, which you can see here, like 1, that will be stored in info, and this is a pointer, okay? Pointer will be pointing to the left node as well as the right node. These are all the instances of the structure, okay? This is one node, this is one node, this is one node, okay? Like that, each node will be pointing to two other nodes. For that we need two pointers. Those two pointers are of the type node. So here we will have struct node star L link and struct node star R link. Okay. And here we have type def struct star node. This we are doing just for the simplification purpose. What's our first step? Our first step is to initialize the node. Let's start from the int main. In int main, I'm creating an item here to store the number in which we'll be assigning that number to the node. And then I'm creating two nodes, root and current. What is root? Root means the top node. This is the root. Okay. And we have the current node, which will be like every time we'll be traveling to one node, that point will be that pointer will be kept. Okay. So here we have initially root as null. So since there is no tree as of now, then we'll have a while loop. Okay. Enter the item to be inserted. That will be taken in item. And if item is not zero, we'll insert item till item becomes zero. Okay. So when item is not zero, what we'll do, root is equal to insert node and we are passing item and root. Okay. So item and root will be passed. Item is nothing but the number which we entered and root is the first node. That will pass and what will be returned is root. Okay. So let's see the function insert node. In insert node, what I have is this for initializing the binary tree. Okay. Here we have a temporary node and which has the info and the L link and R link as null. And if root is null, return temp. Okay, means root is the first node. If it is null, that means only one node should be returned. Else what we'll do is we'll keep two pointers, previous and current, and while current is not equal to null, we'll be traveling to each node. Okay. If the same item is again sent, it will be shown as duplicate items are not allowed and it will return from the function. Else what it will do, it will check if the item is less than the current item, it will place in the left link, else it will place in the right link. Using the previous also, we can do the same thing. After that, what will happen is all the nodes which are less than the root node will be placed in the left and the nodes which are greater will be placed in the right. Okay. After we have created the binary tree, what we'll be doing is we'll be calling the inorder function. Okay. This for printing the order in which the binary tree is. Then we'll call post mirror. What it will do is it will use the pre-order traversal, means post-order traversal. First it will go to the L link, then to the R link. And then instead of printing the node, what we'll do is we'll exchange the node using a temp node. Okay. So let's try to run this program and see. After running the program, we have to enter the node values. So I've entered the numbers from 1 to 6. So initially the binary tree is printed as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the mirror binary tree is printed as 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. Since mirror is the reverse of the normal binary tree. Okay. So this is all for the day 13 of 100 days of code. And thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one.